My dear friends, there are good smells and bad smells, isn't it? Think about all the bad smells. You hate it. And it's so visible when something smells bad. All kinds of deodorants, perfumes, odeclones you use to cover that smell only. And think about your thoughts. Dirt smells bad. What about dirty thoughts? If God inflicted bad smell to your sins, your thoughts, lust will have a different kind of smell. Greed, another smell. Terrible bad smell. And your anger will be smelling horrible. What would you think? Moment you think something, it will betray, the smell will betray your thought. You know, you won't be able to live in office. You won't be able to live in your vehicle, in your own house and place, because it will be smelling terrible, because all the thoughts are very bad. The Lord is saying today, not what enters your mouth, what enters into the mouth does not make a poison unclean. What defiles a person is what comes out of his mouth. So Pharisees, they were so worried about washing their hands. That was their culture. They're so worried about the hands. I mean, about the skin. But beneath the skin, they never took a notice of it. But the Lord is saying, I look into your heart, your intention, your thoughts. So if it is dirty, if it is stinking, what's the matter of washing your hands only? You know, if you're psychologically wretched, broken, if a person has been used in her childhood, in her or his childhood, one syndrome we see, he used to wash his hand many times. That's one syndrome. They take bath for a long time because they think they are dirty. So it's as a compensation, as a cover-up, they wash themselves more and more. But then their inside remain dirty always. That guilt will devour them. That's why the Lord is saying, what is inside of you? Cleaning, washing a cloth. The soap will go between the cloth and the dirt. And it is being separated. Cleansing the gold. The fire will test the gold. But the Lord says, I will test you. Not like fire testing gold, but as with your pain, rejection, I'm going to test you. That's why the Lord is speaking about punishment in the first reading. Jeremiah speaks about the punishment. But the Lord is saying, Jeremiah 30 verse 11, I won't destroy you, but yet I punish you. Appropriate, proportionate punishment I'll give you. My dear friends, that's why in purifying the temple, Jesus made a scourge and hit the people. He made it. That denotes the appropriate, proportionate punishment. He will punish you to test your heart. He will make you go through pain to purify your thought. So never grumble in your pain. It's a detergent powder. It's a soap which helps you to clean yourself. Pain has power to clean. Purify. Pain has a power to purify as a fire, as a soap. So let our hearts be open to Him. Let's go to Him as we are. Tell the truth about ourselves without hiding any dirt, any sin, any blunder that we made. And He will purify you. But that process causes pain. Pain is a healer. pain can have, pain has power to heal you. Think about it. Praise the Lord in all your pain. And allow that pain to purify your heart, thoughts, not externally, but internally. Examine your heart and see how dirty it is. And try to wash your sins with the precious blood of Jesus. And praise the Lord as you are. Amen. May God bless you.